Hi friends, in our today's lecture, we are going to discuss about duplicate genes. Duplicate genes, they are also called as pseudo alleles. Now, we are going to study how exactly they show their existence and the dominance. Now, what do we mean by duplicate genes? Duplicate genes, these are the two pairs. Now, these two pairs, they are found on different chromosomes. So they are found on different chromosomes, but the phenotypic effect they produce is same. That means even if they are present in a group, or if both the dominant alleles are present, or even if a single dominant allele is present, but the phenotypic results remain the same, or it is nearly same. It is nearly same in case of dominant. So the definition of duplicate genes is, these are the two pairs of genes which determine the same or nearly same phenotype in dominant state. This inheritance, it was studied by Shull. Shull studied on one of the plant and the name is Schaeffer's pears. The fruit shape which was found in Schaeffer's pears, it is ideally triangular. So triangular is considered to be the dominant trait, and elongated is considered to be the recessive trait. So most of the fruits or the pods which are found in Schaeffer's pears, they bear triangular pods as compared to elongated, because it is recessive. Now we'll see how exactly the cross has to be done for the duplicate genes, which are also called as pseudo alleles. Now when we are saying that triangular is dominant, so we are now going to take one parent with a triangular pod shape, and the other is with elongated, which is considered to be the recessive. So triangular, this is the parental generation. Elongated, if both recessive will come, then only this trait will be shown. Now gametes, the cross has to be done. This will be our first generation, and as these are the duplicate genes, in first generation all the pods will be of triangular shape, because both the alleles are dominant, that is T and D. Now upon selfing, as usual, we are going to get four different gametes here. Same we are supposed to write here. By the time we all know how to do the cross, and upon doing this cross, obviously how many combinations we are going to get here? 16 different combinations we are going to get here after the cross. Now see, when the cross is done, the gametes 4 into 4, we get F2 generation. All these 16 combinations, out of these 16 combinations, now it is interesting to know here that the 15 are of triangular shape, and only one which has all the four alleles which are homozygous recessive will only show the inheritance of elongated shaped pods because this has resemblance with its parents, and rest all will be triangular. Now note here, even if in this case 3 are recessive, only one is dominant, no problem. This will also be a triangular pod. In any of the case here, only T is dominant, but still this will be the triangular. Why it is triangular? Because the dominant alleles will show the phenotype of triangular pods. So irrespective of T, D, both combinations, all the 15 will be with a triangular shaped pod. So what we are supposed to note here, triangular shape is dominant factor, and both the alleles, capital T and capital D, they either, if even if they are singly or collectively, will produce the dominant trait. The dominant trait is triangular. If the individual is homozygous recessive for both the genes, the last case, then only it will produce the elongated shape, and that is the reason the dihybrid ratio of duplicate genes, it is 15:1. So this is something to remember here. The ratio is 15:1. So it is clear from the cross that if the cross is done, triangular shape is dominant, and both the genes, either it is present singly or collectively, will produce the dominant trait, that is the triangular shape. And only the trait is seen in one individual among the total 16 combinations where the homozygous recessive condition for both the alleles is present. So the duplicate genes are also called as pseudo alleles. Duplicate genes are also called as pseudo alleles. Now why they are called as pseudo alleles? Pseudo means false. So duplicate genes, they are also called as pseudo alleles. Now the example we have already seen is for pseudo alleles, or for the, it is Stafford's purse. The scientific name of this is Capsella bursa pastoris, and it belongs to the family, that is Brassicaceae. One more example is there apart from Stafford's purse. It is oat black grain. Oat black grain, it is dominant over the white grain. It also follows the law of duplicate genes or pseudo alleles. So just we'll take a quick recap. Duplicate genes, they are two or more independent genes which are found on different chromosomes, which produce same or nearly similar phenotypic effect in dominant state. And the example that we had already discussed is of oat black grain, which is dominant over the white, plus the shepherd's purse, the shape of the pods. Triangular shape was dominant over the elongated shape. And duplicate genes are also called as pseudo alleles. The cross we have done here, triangular was dominant over the elongated. These are the parental genotypes. The gametes produced F1 generation, all the plants will bear triangular pods. As usual, we are doing the cross here. Gametes are formed 4:4, 16 combinations, but the ratios are quite different here because this is the case of duplicate genes or pseudo alleles. So triangular we get 15. Even if any single dominant gene is present, it will produce the triangular shaped pod. And the elongated is seen only in homozygous recessive. So what we are supposed to remember? Triangular shape is dominant factor, and even if capital T and small t, both the genes either singly or collectively produce this dominant trait, if the individual is homozygous recessive, the last case, if it is homozygous recessive for both the genes, then only elongated shape pons can be produced. Today we are going to discuss one more terminology, that is heterosis. Now what do we mean by heterosis? Heterosis is also known as hybrid vigor. Always remember, whenever there is any cross between any plant or any animal, the new generation which has been produced is considered to be the hybrid generation, or we can say F1, F2 generation is the hybrid generation. Now the main aim of doing this hybridization program is to obtain the superior progeny than their parents. So heterosis means the increased vigor. So the increased vigor, it may be in form of size, it may be in the form of its strength or stamina, and that is called as hybrid vigor. And the hybrid, it has to be always superior than its parents. Heterosis or hybrid vigor, this was also, the concept was given by Schell in 1910. He proposed the term heterosis for the superiority of hybrids. If at all the hybrid is superior, then only we can use this term heterosis. Now, why we are supposed to do these hybridization programs, or why hybrid vigor is important? If we say, in case of plants, for plants, the hybridization can be done for increased height, it can be done for the viability, it may be the viability of seed, then for greater yield of fruits or seeds, increased resistance for pest, insect, or it may be for the stress, and the stress, it may be the environmental stress. So in plants, hybrid vigor, it is developed for its height, viability, greater yield, it may be fruit, it may be seeds, for increased resistance, pest, insect resistance, to cope up with the environmental stresses. Plus, it helps in better seed germination also. So, it helps in better seed germination. Now, example if we could take of plants, the examples are tomato, onion, there are some grasses, tobacco, cotton, sugarcane. Most of the plants we obtain hybrid vigor. Same like in plants, we can go through the hybrid vigor, or we can obtain hybrid vigor in animals also. So the hybridization programs are done in animals also. So it may be for the milk production in cattle, then it can be also done for the increased number of eggs in poultry animals, most of the poultry animals, for better beef and pork output. The animals can be hybridized. Mule is a very good example of the hybrid. Mule, it has more strength. It is the hybridization done between male donkey, that is Jack, and female horse. That is mare. And mule, ideally they are used in mountain areas where they can carry maximum load. So mules are developed in same way. Hinny is also developed. Hinny is the cross of female donkey, that is Jenny, and a male horse, that is stallion. Same way, the zebronky is also produced, which is a cross between zebra and donkey. So hybrid vigor is important, which produces the superior progeny. But here we need to remember one thing, that in case of animals, when the hybridization is done, mule, hinny or zebronky all are sterile. That means they can't reproduce. So we'll just take an overview again. Once again, heterosis is also known as hybrid vigor. That means the increased vigor. It may be in the form of size, strength, stamina of hybrid than its parents. So it also can be defined as a hybrid is always superior than their parents. This term heterosis was proposed by Schell in 1910. In plants, the heterosis is expressed in the form of height, viability, greater yield of fruits, seeds, increased resistance, pest, insect, environmental stress, and for better germination of seeds. It is been seen in plants also, like tomato, onion, grasses, tobacco, sugarcane. Various examples we could quote here. Among animals, it is expressed in the form of milk production in kettles. Increased number of eggs can be obtained. Better beef and pork outputs can be achieved by hybridization technique. There are some examples, mule and hinny, which is the cross between, mule is a cross between male donkey and a female horse. And hinny is a cross between female donkey and a male horse. Now, hope it is clear. Today we had discussed two things, duplicate genes and the heterosis. Hope it is clear. If you have any doubt, you can come back to me. Stay home, stay safe.